Today on Sports Central, we'll be going over our next schedule preview this offseason, and it will be over the Utah Utes. And this is a team that went 11-3 in the 2019 season. And overall, they were a huge surprise team in 2019. I'd mark them as one of my top three most surprising teams of the 2019 season. But either way, how would they do in 2020? It's what we're going over here today. We'll be going over a few players that this team will be losing, who they're going to be returning, and also going over their schedule for the first time this offseason. Starting off with the games that Utah has had since November, we start off on November 2nd when they play Washington on the road in Seattle. They got the win there, 33-28. They had a blowout win against UCLA the following week, 49-3. They also had a win against Arizona on the road, 35-7, and then a blowout win at Colorado to finish off the season, 45-15. So, yeah, that November was really good for Utah for sure, being able to beat Washington in a tough location and then also blowing out UCLA, Arizona, and Colorado. I mean, this Utah team was looking really good heading into the Pac-12 championship game, but it didn't really turn out all that well. They ended up losing to Oregon big time in that one, 15-37, and then their bowl game against Texas really did not go as planned. That was a huge loss as well, 10-38. So, overall, at the end of the season, in the postseason for Utah, it was not a very good turnout for them, but overall, this season was great otherwise, no doubt on that one. Of course, they went 11-1 during the regular season. So, Utah was a great team other than the last couple of games. Maybe between September and October, they were 7-1. Then between November and the rest of the season, they were 4-2. Moving on to your returning production for Utah, they lose their starting quarterback in Tyler Huntley. He was a big, big part of this team last season as he had just over 3,000 yards with 19 touchdowns and only 4 interceptions. So his touchdown interception ratio was really good last season at just about a 5-1. They do lose their top running back in Zach Moss, which he had just over 1,800 yards with 17 touchdowns. So their two major playmakers on their offense are both going to be gone heading into 2020. That is certainly a big concern for me. They do return their top receiver slash tight end, Brant Kwith, which he had just over 700 yards with 9 touchdowns. So that's good to be able to return him. They also return their top wide receiver, Brian Thompson, as he had just over 460 yards. They also returned their second wide receiver in Jalen Dixon. So this receiving corps is looking really good heading into 2020, especially if you consider that their top receiver slash tight end, if you consider him a receiver, they returned their second and third ones as well. So yeah, their only wide receiver, their only receiver loss would be technically their fourth one at Damari Simpkins, which he had just right around 400 yards as well. So yeah, this receiving corps is looking really good. As far as the quarterback and running back situations go, I am a little bit concerned. Once again, when you lose Zach Moss, who had just right around almost 2,000 yards for that matter, and Tyler Huntley, who had over 3,000 yards of passing last season, it does concern me a little bit heading into 2020. But they do lose one offensive lineman, so that's good. Only one loss there. They do lose three defensive linemen, though. This defensive line is taking a major hit there. They also lose one linebacker, as well as three in the secondary. So this defense loses 7 starters. So, yeah, this defense is something to be concerned about. But yeah, will Utah win their division again? Certainly their division in the South is really wide open. It was like that last season, and I expect it to be like that heading into 2022. So certainly for Utah, it is wide open. They definitely could, but it just depends on the quarterback situation, especially the running back situation too. If they can get a good quarterback to take over after Tyler Huntley, certainly I think this Utah team is bound for a really great season in 2020. We also got to remember the running back situation too. Losing Zach Moss was a really tough thing, certainly to deal with. So yeah, for Utah, either way, definitely think it'll be a great season. I'm not sure it'll be as good as 2019. I don't think they'll have an 11-win regular season by any means, but I do expect this Utah team to be good heading into 2020. Looking at your schedule, you start off on September 3rd against BYU. I believe that's on a Thursday. Then you got Montana State again, or on September 12th is what I should say, so you got them at home. Then you got Wyoming and California in the following weeks, both on the road. You got USC to kick off October, as well as Washington State and Washington in the following weeks. You finish off October with UCLA on the road. Then in November, you got Arizona, Oregon State, Arizona State, and Colorado. So overall, your November isn't terrible. I'd say your toughest month of the year would have to be October, having USC, Washington State, then Washington all in consecutive weeks, and then a road game to UCLA to finish it off. Certainly for Utah, I think it will be a bit of a tough October, but otherwise, here's what I'm going to be estimating here. I'll give you 3 guaranteed wins. Once again, we don't go over every game in our schedule previews. We will be doing that in our actual predictions. But yeah, I'm going to give you Montana State, Wyoming, then Oregon State, and I consider putting on BYU there too, but of course, BYU always plays Utah close, so I decided not to do that. Their record estimation will be 8-4 to 9-3 for the regular season. Once again, I don't expect them to get 11 wins once again next season. There's just too many losses. When you lose your starting quarterback, who was great for you last season, as well as your top running back, who certainly was a great running back for sure. It's going to be tough to deal with. It's tough for any team to deal with that. And certainly for Utah being a team that isn't all that great at recruiting, it's just the fact there. But yeah, I definitely think Utah, I mean, they're bound for a great season. I mean, this offensive line is going to be great. This defense does take a couple of hits, though. But either way, record estimation is going to be 8-4 to 9-3. I mean, that's still a great record, especially for Utah being a team that has had some success in the past, but not a lot. That should still be a great season for Utah. I still expect them to reach that 8 or 9 win marker. Now, that's about wraps up this schedule preview. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below on Utah. Let me know whether you think they'll be better or worse. Yeah, thanks all for watching once again. Stay tuned for more from All Sports Central. If you enjoyed this schedule preview, be sure to slap a like on it. Also, subscribe. It really helps out the channel. And I'd really appreciate that as well. But yeah, once again, thanks all for watching. Once again, stay tuned for more. I will see you all later.